Actor Jamie Foxx apologized over the weekend after a post that he put up on Instagram led to accusations of anti-Semitism. I'm gonna show you the post and then we'll get to the explanations. He had posted this: "They killed this dude named Jesus. What do you think they'll do to you? Hashtag fake friends, hashtag fake love." Now those hashtags are super relevant and we'll get to why in just a moment. But I can also understand why he received backlash for that. So the interpretation was that Foxx's post promoted the idea of Jewish deicide, described as the charge that Jews bear eternal responsibility for the death of Jesus Christ per the American Jewish Committee. Now, it is true that this is a talking point that has been levied by anti-Semitic people to justify violence toward Jewish people. However, there's also a miscommunication and a bit of a disconnect culturally speaking here, because apparently this is a phrase, a colloquialism, if you will, within the black community. And so there is actually an explanation here before we get to that. After appearing to have repeated that trope, Foxx was dragged over the coals. So a wider frame, a newsletter that says it aims to provide a better overall understanding and scope of Jewish world news, shared Foxx's original post and called it horrifically anti-Semitic. Actor Jennifer Aniston then reposted a wider frame after she said that she came under fire for seeming to have liked his post. So here's what she wrote, which you tell me if you can decipher what she means here, right? Because she said, quote, "This really makes me sick. I did not like this post on purpose or by accident."
Well, it's gotta be one of those.
It's gotta be one of them, right? Because that has happened to me where I'm like scrolling through Twitter or scrolling through Instagram and I accidentally like something, right? That I don't actually like. So I'm like, maybe it was an accident. I don't think, you know what I mean? But when she puts out that statement, I'm like, well, it's one or the other. What do you mean here? But anyway, the rest of her post says, "I did not like this post on purpose or by accident. And more importantly, I want to be clear to my friends and anyone hurt by this showing up on their feed. I do not support any type of anti-Semitism and I truly don't tolerate hate of any kind, period." Now, she also got a little bit of backlash for that comment because they felt like she turned on a good friend of hers, because I don't think that he meant to say anything anti-Semitic there. Number one, Jamie Foxx does not have a history of anti-Semitism. If he did, if there was anything else questionable in his past, I'd be like, I don't know. However, I wanna give you his apology, because in his apology, there's an explanation that I do think is that has merit. He says, "I want to apologize to the Jewish community and everyone who was offended by my post. I now know my choice of words have caused offense and I'm sorry. That was never my intent. To clarify, I was betrayed by a fake friend and that's what I meant with they, not anything more. I only have love in my heart for everyone. I love and support the Jewish community. My deepest apologies to anyone who was offended." So apparently there's like this figure of speech saying type thing within the black community where they're trying to make a point about how those closest to you can sometimes be the fakest and could sometimes be the most harmful to you, right?
Yeah, I wouldn't know anything about that. Okay, so first of all, I'm gonna explain who actually killed Jesus in a minute.
But thank God.
Yes, but let's address whether these folks are anti-Semitic or not. Sometimes I feel like I might be overly sensitive on this issue because I grew up with so many friends who are Jewish. Same thing on it with stories that relate to Asians, etc. I try not to be. You have to look out for everybody at this in the same exact way, okay? And so my radar is up on it, partly because I grew up knowing those anti-Semitic tropes because I had grew up with so many Jewish friends, right? And here as well. Anyways, but even so, this one didn't ring an alarm for me. Why? Because context matters, and the statement matters. So number one, if it was Kanye West, well, he has a long history of saying anti-Semitic things, so it would not be at all surprising, and I would assume that it was anti-Semitic because of that context. Jamie Foxx has no such context, none, right? Second of all, I can read. It says hashtag fake friends, hashtag fake love. Why would you put that in an anti-Semitic post? I just don't understand how it would be logically connected, right? So 100% pardon for Jamie Foxx. And Jennifer Aniston's first line was totally confusing.
Right.
But other than that, 100% pardon for her for liking this, and 100% pardon also for the statement. She didn't throw Jamie Foxx under the bus. I mean, at worst, that statement was massively confusing, but she didn't say Jamie Foxx did anything wrong. She just says, I'm not in favor of anti-Semitism either, right? Which is the same thing Jamie Foxx says. And so guys, if you make everything racist, anti-Semitic, bigoted, sexist, then nothing is. So you have to use it when it is appropriate, okay? And not just for the super extreme cases where some anti-Semite goes in and kills a bunch of people in a synagogue, but no, when somebody says there are good people on the Nazi side, right? When somebody goes and speaks in front of Jewish leaders and goes, nobody knows how to negotiate better than this room, right? And let alone dining with Nazis, it's that we can go on and on. Those are real cases of anti-Semitism. They're here, they're real. And the right, and anti-Semitic attacks have risen tremendously since the Trump era began. But this ain't it. And so if you call this anti-Semitic, you're gonna lose credibility.
And
so
look,
it doesn't help anyone.
To the ADL's credit, Jonathan Greenblatt with the Anti-Defamation League put out a statement after Jamie Foxx's apology and explanation, saying we welcome Jamie Foxx's apology and thank him for his clarification. Furthermore, we wish him well as he recovers from his prior hospitalization.
Great.
By the way, he was hospitalized and he's recovering. The details of his illness has not been disclosed, and we don't need to know. That's his personal business. Greenblatt also wrote, truly appreciate Jamie Foxx reaching out and confirming privately what he also said publicly. His message of love for the Jewish community is crucial in this time of rising hate. We are stronger together. And so, look, I think the biggest lesson to learn from this particular case is it's okay to try to interpret people as charitably as possible, right? Give them a chance to explain themselves. And clearly there was an easy explanation here for why he used the phrase that he did. And you know, you gotta be a little careful because a colloquialism within your community might not come across as such to the broader community. But the explanation makes a lot of sense to me, and I don't think that Jamie Foxx is anti-Semitic in any way.
Yeah, so last couple of things here. First of all, Jonathan Greenblatt, I like what he said about Jamie Foxx, and that's good. You don't want to be a boy who cries wolf. Love that he clarified it, and he's done a great job in fighting back against anti-Muslim bigotry, etc., as has the entire ADL. On the other hand, Greenblatt is one of the people who abuses the word anti-Semitism the most when it comes to honest policy disagreements about Israel. If you disagree about anything that Israel's doing, Greenblatt's gonna call you an anti-Semite. Happy, he does it every time, and he's gotta reel that back in. We don't want you losing credibility. We don't want ADL losing credibility. We're in the middle of really important fights for all of us, okay? So please keep policy differences out of, you know, calling people names. And so it happens far too often. Unfortunately, it happens a lot on the left, and we are on the left, and that doesn't help anybody's cause. So now the next thing I want to say is, Anna's absolutely right, and I have a rule inside the company here for everybody. Don't assume bad intent. Things go awry when your first assumption is bad intent. No, look at the full context, and if you see a context that shows bad intent, then okay, that's fine, right? But assume good intent until you find out otherwise. That should be a rule of thumb, whether it's politics or at work or within your family and friends, etc. And then lastly, I promised you who killed Jesus. So I talk about this in my book. You could order it at tyt.com/justice. We'll have a link down below. I explain how progressive Jesus is and how he would make Karl Marx blush. That's also part of that same segment. But in this case, it's not the Jews didn't kill Jesus. And some say, you know, SNL famously joked in a skit that it was the Italians because the Romans did it. No, plenty of Jews disagreed, plenty of Romans disagreed. It was the conservatives who killed Jesus. It was the conservatives who said he is overthrowing an established system, and we don't like that. He is going against our traditions, whether they're Roman or Jewish traditions, and we want him eliminated. So the only people who agreed to kill Jesus were conservatives. That's in the Bible, so it is what it is. You asked, I told you. Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.